God. Praise God. Let us bow down for a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, it's that moment that we've come before your throne of mercy. We are asking for forgiveness of sins. Cleanse us with the blood that was spilled on Calvary. Prepare our minds and hearts to receive your word. We pray and rebuke every demonic power that is going to tamper with the word of God that is going to come forth. May this word find good soil in our hearts. Let it take root and let it multiply so that we can give fruits tenfold, twentyfold, hundredfold to the glory and honor of your name. Let us decrease as you increase. Be glorified in this service of your word is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of a loving Father. Amen. It is a subject that I've done quite research, and even today in the morning, we were polishing through this sermon. And the title of my message today is about sonship. Amen? Sonship. Praise God.
Amen.
You know, a while ago, I think about 9 years ago, it was on August 6th, I think, if I'm not wrong, I got a phone call and I was told that your wife is blessed with a baby boy. So I didn't have a son at that time. I was so excited. So I rushed all the way to St. Mary's to see this guy who has been born. Praise God. When I reached there, I was told the baby has been put in the nursery. So I asked those guys, what are you saying? Well, Kasema. And the boy was disturbed, and when he was being born, he really strained, and he doesn't have enough oxygen. So as any concerned parent, you panic. To kind of kakana daktari, I asked him, doc, what's happening? And the doctor told me very bad news, and by the way, that you know, the guy really strained to come out, and his brain, he will not be a normal child. He's not going to function. He's not going to function. And by the way, me, I believe what God says more than what the doctor says. Because daktari anagonjeka mkufa. Yesu alikufa na akafufuka. Amen. You know, doctors, yes, they're professionals, but they're human beings. And they have limitations. As human beings, I mean, they're limited. There are things they don't even understand, even if they try to, you know. That is the first thing I say. Hakuna kitu kama hiyo. So the guy told me, this guy, so tukakana yetu kamuliza what happened, you know, brain yake. Nikasema, he will not function, he will not be a normal child. Nikasema hii, the prophecy kutoka kuzimu. I refused. So my wife was there. So I think after 2 days of Kasema, the boys out of the nursery, I went. You know, ukienda kuona katoto unataka kujua kanafanana nani. If you are a man. So I'm looking at the guy, the nose looks like me. You can see the eyes look like me. Nashindwa now, this. And you know, when babies are born, they are very tiny. You know, how many people have seen a 1 year old vile kanaka? One day old. Like few hours. So unaambiwa shika mtoto. You know when you hold that child, ni kama umeshika kamkate. There is nothing, there is no weight. Sasa unaambiwa ni mtoto. And I don't know, fathers, if you are here, you can bear me witness. Ukishika mtoto wako for the first day, you don't understand what you are holding. Whenever you need umeshika. Amen. Just track with me, I'm going somewhere. Then you hold that kid like this. Because I was told what you need to do as a father, you need to pray. You need to prophesy to that child the first time you've seen them. You will be a great man, blah, blah, blah. You pray for that child. Because it is the first prayer. Because even those who assist in giving birth, wakunga, I'm told some speak demonic words. So you come there and also you counsel. You say you'll be a great man. You'll be a man of God. You'll be used by God, blah, blah, blah. You know, you are saying things to that child. You are prophesying to their destiny. That is a good culture. Oh, mama. The first time the parent appear mdolo, no, start praying over that child. Start declaring things over that child. Because it is called the law of first declaration. The first things you are saying is you are a great person of God, you are protected, you will be prosperous. The words you are speaking, it's a prophecy. And let me tell you, that prophecy will come to pass. Amen? Amen. So I hold the guy, I speak my things, I take back the boy. So a few days later, he's discharged, we come home. So we stay. After 6 months, unambiwa. Imagine kaneza kunywa uji. Then you're like, this guy can also drink porridge like me. Kumpe. Lakini wanasema kikapu kadogo, sijui iweke maziwa na muipitishe kwa kichungi. System yake ija, you understand? Katoto kana, wanasema kwa winning, eh? Kanapewa food 6 months. Kana kaka wanafika 1 year, wanasema, haka sasa kaneza kula ugali kieko kwa supu. Haya, kajamaka meneza kula ugali kama sisi. And then after some time, unaona kamutu kameza kutamba. Everybody is excited. They are called milestones. Amen? Sinimo ndio wanazita. Sasa siku wa mama wanafurahi kwa siku zote. It is the day the child walks. Unajua kanasimama kanaanguka, kanasimama kanaanguka. Kati tembe unasikia kila mtu wame scream. Kame mbea! You know? Okay. For men, you want him to walk. But you don't see anything serious on walking because you expect him to walk anyway. Then the boy walks and everybody's happy. And kama jamea meno, inaanza kupea mama stress. Mtoto wangu amefika 1 year, 7 months, yoni meno. You know meno, watoto wote, it's not the same. Kuna yenye wanatoa mapema, wengine wana delay. Then inafika mahali kamemaliza kutoa meno, kakitoa tu meno tuwili, sijui chini ama juu. Everybody is excited. Kakono tumeno tuwi. Amen? And I mean, the most gentle and beautiful smile ni smile ya katono kakono tumeno tuwi. Praise God. Are people getting what I'm saying? Ata kakicheka na tumeno tuwi, everybody is happy. Amen? Because this child is attaining milestones. Amen? I don't know how do you call milestones in Kiswahili. Atua? How do you call milestones? Ni atua? And I make strides. No, anyway, come out when to Google to find the equivalent of milestone. So, kakimaliza hapo, kanatembea, kamimaliza kutamba, kametembea, people celebrate. Kanapata tumeno, people celebrate. What else do you want? Now, it reaches Maria's speech. Praise God. Kanaza kusema tu vitu atueleweki, ba, kila mtu anafurahi. But, katoto pia kakichelewa kuongea, stress. Amen? Mama anashikwa na stress. Like I know my daughter mother alichelewa kidogo kuongea. Mama ako na stress. Sasa huyu ataenda shule na huyu vizuri. And you are like, they don't talk at the same, you understand? So kajamaka kafika kanaanza kuongea. Tu vitu hivi atuelewi. Siku moja kanasema, mama, baba. And I think mothers are professionals in teaching them how to speak. Sasa kanaanza kuongezewa vocabulary. Kanaongezewa, siku moja kanaongea majina, sometimes kanaongea vitu hatuelewi. Kanajiongelesha. Kako serious, but there's something he's saying. Nobody can understand it. You can imagine mtoto wako abaki kwa maisha yake yote, anaongea hivyo na uelewi. How many people will be happy? You'll be frustrated. Amen. As a parent, you expect mtoto advance language speaking, muelewane, sijui kama tuko pamoja. So, akifika mahali, anasema nasikia njaa, tumbo. Alafu, you know, we don't call it food. How do we say? How do you call food to the baby language? Now, yum yum. Praise God. So, you introduce a language, yes, yanaelewa. Chakula hiki chakula inaitwa nyamnyam. Na kanaelewa. Amen. So that is the language for a child. Praise God. So kaduka kanaambiwa nyamnyam, kanashika. Amen. So kameanza ku relate language, inaanza kukua introduced.
kakionyesha mtoto mwingine akaambia mtoto kanaambia mtoto mnapata hebu. Yaani hii amtaki kukapea jina full so that can mind yake inaweza. Amen. So I think after that mtoto speech inakuwa developed. Everybody is happy. The child can talk. And another big milestone is the first day they go to school. My goodness. The excitement on mothers, katipa uniform, for the first day. Kanabarisha uniform kanabare kwa baby school. Amen. I think the boy was taken to Mount Lavender. People are excited. Kanabibwa picture. I mean, it's like a monument. Amen. See, that's another milestone. Kanaenda shule. I wish you see first day babies wakipele kwa baby class, the way mothers behave. Yani unaona ni kama mama ni yeye anaenda kusoma anaanza shule. And it's very nostalgic. And it's very sensational, sentimental. The emotions are too much. So sometimes mama anaenda lakini hataki kwenda. Anaambiwa na mwalimu wewe aenda atakuwa sawa. Anaenda wengine wanaenda wanarudi kuchungulia kutoka kwa kuadilisha. Wanaangalia ako sawa. I mean, hawataki kumwachilia. Praise God. That is a stage. And then mtoto pia hataki kuacha mama yake. Wengine wanalia the whole day. Jioni wanakuja. But mwalimu wa preschool aliniambia watoto wanafaa wazoeshwe wajue unakwenda home, kuenda shule na kurudi home. Unakwenda shule na kurudi home. Unakwenda shule na kurudi home. Ah, wanafika wana understand. Hata nikienda jioni nitaru, they get peace with that. They become school going. That is preschool. Now, I don't want to go to the details of how they scribble, how they kuandika, wana, you know, wanamaliza. Now, as all this is taking place as a father, you're looking yourself in that guy, wanamaliza preschool. Now, very interesting things start happening. Katoto kakifika, let's say, grade 1 or 2, kanamuliwa suti, kanavalishi wanaviani. Sasa ukikaangalia, enye unaona huyu ni kama ni mimi. Lakini ni mimi mtoto. I don't know if you're getting the point. This is me, but me a child. Amen? Now, as a father, what do you pray for at that stage? Do you pray, alikaendelea kuvaa suti kakikeroka na kashana hivyo? Now, let me tell you. When these boys start to grow, whenever, they reach a certain age, I think from about 7 years and above, they start behaving exactly like their father. Praise God. There is a day, I think, not kitambo. I went somewhere to play golf. So, huko kuna hata, you put a shot, you tap him, you put a chain. So, when the boy saw me the first day, the following day, aliambia mama yake, nataka shot, nataka sport shoes, na nataka kofia. Praise God. Hasa jamaa akavalishwa short, t-shirt, akataki, vile aliona. Akafika mahali tulikuwa tunaenda, we were fellowshipping somewhere. Akasema ninunulie kofia nikae kama wewe. Because that afternoon I had golf lessons. Tukamnunulia kofia. Bas. Sasa akajua, me, I'm like that guy. Finish story. Amen. What does this have to do with sonship? Very simple. Everything. Everything. When you get born again, amen, you are a baby. You are a baby. Kuomba ujui, kufunga ujui, kusoma neno ujui, ngoma bado unasikia ni za wild. God anaanza kukuongelesha kama mtoto nyam-nyam. Yani, anakupeleka through the stages. Because a baby Christian, there is such a thing as a baby Christian. You are born again, and let me shock you. Baby Christian, ya kiombaka kitu Mungu anafanya immediately. Sijui kama mnajua hivyo, mtu akiokoka, akiomba kitu, Mungu amdelay. Vitu zinakujanga haraka upesi. Why? Mungu anaelewa, huyu mtu, mahali yako msipo mjibu maombi yake saa hivi anataka, we will lose it. Amen? Because at that stage, watu wangapi wanajua mtoto akiwa 0 to 3 years, ile kitu analilia anapewa? I mean, naturally, mtoto akiwa 0 to 3, akianza kulilia kitu, Watu wangapi wanamnyima ama wanampenda ya jamaze? Si anapewa? Eti gani ndio inafika? Hata asikulilia, akiomba kitu anaambiwa sio sahihi. Akiinsist anaangaliwa tu hivi anajua kumedhoka. Praise God. Kuna age unafika. Sijui millennials we survive suicide. Mama anaweza kuwekelea hata sufuria. Sababu mwiko ile kitu iko karibu ndio anakusort nayo. Yaani at that age hakuna kupembelezwa. Umundu kumundu. Yeah. Watu wangapi wanajua kwa kulikuwa na sheria past 6 jioni uwezi ingia kwa boma? Yeah, past saa 12 uwezi ingia kwa boma. What does that tell you? Now, those are called family standards. Zenye unafuata na mzazi wako. Even God as our Father, we are standards. And God expects us to follow those standards. But if you are a baby Christian, God can understand. Anaangalia najua hii ni nyamnyamu. Hii mtoto unaacho. Lakini ukikaa kwa wokovu 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, unaanza kupita kwa moto. Amen. Because God understands that through fire is hardening you. Amen. Praise God. Mtoto inafika mahali anaekwa chini anaekelewa bell. Kadhaa. Anaambiwa ukikula ni chacha, uwezi kula tu wapa. Sawa, sawa. But this is the same son I was learning. Nimeona kakigrow. But as the boy is transitioning to a man, you teach him. You give him guidelines and principles and boundaries as a son. Amen? You know, people expect to come to God and remain babies forever. It doesn't work like that. Praise God. It's because in the kingdom of God, God has expectations. Praise God. Now, mtoto akikuwa mkubwa, akianza kuwa between teenage na adulthood. Si unaona mtoto anataka kujitawala, anataka aunde rules zake. Aseme ile kitu anakula. Watu wangapi wanaacha mtoto anadecide anakula nini akifika teenage? Ati jamaa anaweza simama tu aseme leo tunakula nyama na ugali. Kesho aseme anataka chips na kuku. Nani anakubalika mtoto afanye kitu kama hiyo? No, no, be honest. Nani anakubali mtoto ampatie menu? Kwa nini? Si ni mtoto? Kwa nini? Sasa, mjamaa, unaingia ndani ya masharti. Ile yenye unapewa ndio unakuu? Na sio kafaka? Na ukikataa unaambiwa lala njaa. Praise God. Ukirumba, wanasema kurumba. Wakisi wanasema kuhira. Ukisema sikuli, wanasema okay. Watu wakule, wajamaa lale. Njaa inakunyorosha kesho asubuhi uwezi kata food. You know what is really happening is you are taught in the family structure that it is not always you get what you want. Even in Christianity, sometimes when you ask God now when you have matured, there are three answers God can give you. Yes, no, or wait. Amen? And he seems to like no and wait more than yes. You know, God is not a yes man. Ati unakuja huko, unakuja unaambia Mungu nataka saa hii V8, nataka Range Rover Sport, nataka, hakuna, iye ndivo. Now, God as a father expects us to be obedient. Number one, expectations of God to his sons and daughters. Number one, it is obedience. Same obedience. Same obedience. Because let me tell you, fathers, when you obey them in the house, you have access to everything. Praise God. Mtoto wako akiwa kwa nyumba, let's say, hata akiwa young adult now, ameruka stage, amemaliza 18 years, he's a young adult, ajaenda kwake, ako kwa nyumba yako. Atakuja ile time anataka hata akiwa 18, he won't come, right? Atafanya ile kitu anataka hata akiwa 18, he won't do. But the question is this, as long as anafuata masharti yako, utamnyima food? Praise God, church. Because God uses the family natural setup to explain to us how he expects to engage with us as sons. The fact that nani anakubali mtoto wake akuje kama amelewa, ako 18 years, akuje saa 8 usiku anok, asema yeye ni mwanaume apikiwe.
My friend, hiyo siku mtu akifanya hivyo, tutaenda na yeye kumundo kumundo.
Do you know what that means? Is that there are standards, there are boundaries, zimechorwa, unwritten rules. Your son cannot come at night. Na hapa ndio mama wanakosea. Unajua mama anaweza sneak ampelekea chakula. Lakini baba hawezi kubali story kama hiyo. Baba hawezi kubali wakuwe wazee wawili kwa boma moja. Sheria ni ya baba. Watu kama wanakula saa moja kwa meza sisi wote. Mmoja yuko asiyekuwepo na lake. Sasa these are not rules to make life difficult. These are just laws ama rules of engagement to have a functional family. Amen. So that huyu mtoto akigrow kwake atajua tulikuwa tunaenda hivi tunaenda hivi. Now let me tell you the beauty of any father. The epitome of a father is the day you will sit down and see your sons do the things you are doing.
Pastor Naomi, can I get an amen?
Amen.
When you get most pleasure is when you see your daughter do exactly what you will do. That she can drive, she can cook, she can do your responsibilities now beka. Don't you think that ukitoka duniani unatoka ukiwa happy? Will you be worried when you see them responsible? But what happens when you are a father and you are seeing your grown-up children behaving like kids? Now, Mungu ana expect katika safari yetu ya Kristo tufike mahali tumekoma. Praise God, church. Now, as you mature, as a believer, there are places you don't go. Hakuna mtu anakuambia usiende ba. You have matured, you know, huko ukienda inaharibu. Inakosea Mungu as a father. So you know, my father doesn't want this. My father doesn't want this. My father doesn't want this. Praise God. Now, that is being a daughter or a son of the kingdom. And God as a father, he has expectations about us. Mungu akona matarajio kwa watoto wake. There is a way you behave, God said. People say, who mutu ni tafauti? Who mutu anabiye kama watoto wanani? Exactly, there are only two fathers in this world. There is Lucifer and there is Christ. The children of Christ, daughters of the kingdom, there is a way they dress. Mwanamke anavaa unajua huyu kuna baba yake. And the daughters of Lucifer, there is a way they dress. Praise God. So wacha kuniuliza, ni kuambia vile una dress. Go and check with your father. There are only two fathers in this world. There is Christ and Lucifer. Only two princes. Hakunaka utafanya vile nataka. No, no. You either walking in the flesh or you're walking in the spirit. Either Christ is the one calling the shots or Lucifer. Hakuna in between. Ati, I'm going to do my own thing. Hakunaka tukama your own thing. You will obey one of the two fathers. How many people know that Lucifer is a father? What do you know Lucifer is a father? Can I show you in scripture right now? 1 John 3. Amen. What is it talking about? Children of. We have children. 1 John chapter 3, verse 1. Behold, what manner of love the Father has bestowed upon us, that we should be called what? The sons of God. Therefore the world knoweth us not, because it knew him not. Beloved, now we are the sons of God, and it doth not yet appear what we shall be. But we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Watch this. And every man that has his hope in him purifies himself, even as he is pure. Mm-hmm. Whosoever committed sin transgressed also the law, for sin is the transgression of the law. And you know that he was manifested to take away our sins, and in him is no sin. Whosoever abideth in him sinneth not. If you stay in Christ, you do not sin. Amen. Whosoever sinneth has not seen him, neither known him. Amen. Little children, let no man deceive you. He that doeth righteousness is righteous, even as he is righteous. He that committeth sin is of who?
Verse 8, he that committed sin is of who? For the devil sinned from the beginning. For this purpose the Son of God was manifested, that he might destroy the works of the devil. Whosoever is born of God does not commit sin, for his seed remaineth in him, and he cannot be sin because he is born of God. In this, the children of God are manifest. Praise God. And the children of the devil. Wow. Are you seeing that parallel? They are children of God on one side, and they are children of the devil on the other side. In this, in what? There is something they want to introduce there that is going to distinguish between sons. Actually, the Bible is saying the children of the devil and the children of God. What is it? Praise God, church. Verse 10. Whosoever doeth not righteousness is not of God. Neither he, okay? Whosoever doeth not righteousness is not of God. Neither he that loveth not his brother. For this is the method, the message that you had from the beginning, that we should love one another. Amen? So basically, the Bible is saying that people who are walking in sin, they are not sons of God. Okay, let me be generous and honest enough to say this. You can be a child of God, but you are walking in rebellion. Or you are walking in disobedience. Because the Bible says of Lucifer, when the sons of God, in the book of Job, when the sons of God showed up in heaven, Lucifer also came. Meaning, when God summoned his son, one of his rebellious sons, Lucifer, showed up. And they asked him, where are you coming from? Okay? Because the Bible says Lucifer was in Eden, the Garden of Eden. So as an angel, because the Bible says angels are ministering spirits, Lucifer was supposed to minister to Adam. But this is what happened, and this is the greatest travesty that happened that turned Lucifer into Satan. Lucifer was not created to be worshipped. He was created to serve man, just like all angels serve man. Because this dimension of earth and dominion was given to man. But man decided to follow instructions from someone who is supposed to serve him. Now the master became the servant became the master. Because the moment Lucifer convinced Adam, and Adam obeyed what Lucifer said, Adam, that transaction between man and Lucifer is what created Satan. It was Lucifer before the fall of man. Now, the very guy who was supposed, ni kama uko na mtumishi anafaa kukusaa, lakini ufike kwa nyumba, mtumishi anza kupea instructions. The moment you start following the instructions of your servant, who becomes the boss at that time? The servant becomes the boss. So here, the Bible is saying that those who do transgression belong to another father. We have two fathers. There is Lucifer, who operates, the Bible says, the spirit of disobedience, the spirit of rebellion, now at work in the children of disobedience. So, Shetani si mtu akona mabao na pembe, ni roho, iko ndani ya watu ambao wanataka kufuata mambo Mungu anasema. It is a spirit of disobedience. Praise God.
Amen.
Now, this battle of obedience is a lifetime battle. Because every single day you obey God, kitabu yako inafungwa, heaven ina declare that is ours. Praise God.
Amen.
And every time anyone walks in disobedience, kitabu ya kuzimu inafungwa, anasema ole ni wetu. Why is this critical? Because the one you obey owns everything about your life. If you walk in obedience, then the one you are obeying is responsible for your welfare. Deonaonanga mama anakuambia, as long as uko kwa hii rufi yangu, utafanya vile mimi nasema. Amen? Wazazi wanapenda hivyo. I was in Molo with my guardians. But you know, I was brought up in Catholic. But now I was being raised by Adventist guardians. Walikuwa nakuambia, kama uko chini ya hii rufi, kwenda church Saturday, sio tafadhali. Ni lazima. Sasa huko, hakuna ile kitu that you choose. Uko kwa hii roof eh, hapa ni saa tu.
Na nilikuwa nati, saa nilikuwa naenda church Saturday, naenda church Sunday. So I don't know, it was prophetic. Anyway, the point I'm trying to say is this. The one you obey has legal rights over your life. Now, this is where the problem occurs. People disobey God and they want the same God to help them. Like there's a woman I saw who lost her child. She said there is no God, God go to hell. But she was walking in disobedience and her father, Lucifer, decided to reward her by taking away the child through suicide. Okay? Now she's coming bitter and angry at God. Now, let me say this, and I don't know how I'll put this so that we understand it. As powerful as God is, God never created robots. He created human beings and gave us free will to choose either to obey Him or to disobey. Praise God.
Amen.
Mungu, ndiye kwa Mungu, lazima kuache ufanye uamuzi unataka kuenda wapi. Hata ukienda kuzimu, na umeamua unaenda kuzimu, Mungu hawezi kuzuia. Sababu akikuzuia atakuwa Mungu, atakuwa na produce robots. So, and this is what the devil understands, that human beings do not understand the power that they carry. We do not understand our power. Because can I say this? When it comes to matters destiny, and when it comes to matters you fulfilling your God-given purpose, God does not have favorites. God does not have grandchildren. Only God has sons and daughters who through their own volition choose to obey Him or otherwise. And let me put it this way, and this is my takeaway. I dare say, when it comes to making decisions, unaona vile mmekuja hapa ni uamuzi. Nani alivurutwa na nguvu yenye elevi akajipata kwa gari? Na akakaa kwa gari akapata nguvu nyingine elevi amelipa fare. Na vile elevi akapata ametembea mengi hapa. Na sasa elevi vile atarudi nyumbani. Nani alifanya hivi? When you come here, you are very intentional. I will wake up, I will shower, I will go to church. Not even the devil can stop you. Why? Because it is given man to decide and make decisions for his destiny. And God expects mature children and sons. The end game of all entire process is that you want a human being who thinks and reasons like you, who argues like you, who do things like you do. Amen. Sasa huyo mtoto akifika mahali ukimpea pesa anaipanga vile wewe unataka ipangwe. Praise God. Ukimpea 100,000 aende kupiga sherehe nazo, anaziweka kwa savings account, anangoja instructions. Ukimwambia umefanya nini anakuambia no, ile pesa niliweka nilikuwa nataka uniambie unataka kufanya aje. Unampea mawaidha, unamwacha. Anaenda anafanya vile wewe unataka. Sasa huyo mtoto is ready to inherit whatever you have. Praise God. And also God, just like earthly fathers, He wants us as Christians or sons and daughters of the kingdom to mature to a level we can forgive people, we can pray for people, we can love people, then we can say we are sons of God. Because Jesus teaches and says, forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. So forgiveness is a result for the sons and daughters of God. Amen. Loving people, you can understand how selfish human beings we are. But if you mature in Christ, unafika mahali, there is a place I went to see a client. And when I went to do survey of that house, I think for the first time, I felt like she's under such oppression. I could feel the oppression even in her face. I left that house in tears. Toka nikaanza kujiuliza, tangu lini nianze kuhurumia my clients? Clients ni mtu wa kulipa. Sasa naingia nifanye kazi naanza kukuhurumia. What is happening to me? You know, I started questioning my empathy skills. Because I could feel, I could discern that she's going through demonic oppression. That she's living way far below her potential. Because that lady, when she speaks English, it is impeccable. But now when you look at the person, the way she's dressed,
And what's happening around that house? Unaona hapa nyote ni people mchane. I don't know if you've seen that. Did you see that guy from South Africa who was so fluent but he was a beggar? How many saw that video clip? There was a guy in South Africa street. Alikuwa anaongea kizungu kama daktari, lakini jamaa kuna sahani anabeba. Nyota kuibiwa. Praise God. So, as sons, when you reach a place, you start deciding, mtu aje kuambia niombe. But in your heart of hearts, you can feel their pain. You can discern and be empathy. Now, let me say this. That is not me. That is Christ. Because I know myself. When I start empathizing for someone, baka machozi natoka, nasimwambi, you know I was hiding my tears. Because I could feel the pain. Hakuniambia, but I could feel the pain. And I told God, give her rest. Whatever it is that she's going through is too much for her. You can see someone and feel that they are going through a lot. Amen? Our fight to kuambia, and the Bible is saying, when we love other people, we are children of God. The hallmark of a son and a daughter of the kingdom, number one, love other people. Amen? Because human beings naturally, we are selfish. So, Mungu akiweka mapenzi yake kwa roho yako, utaanza kupenda watu. Now then you know that you are growing as a son of God. And because children, wale wadogo, ni watu wangapi wanaonanga vile watoto wako. Unampatia switch tag na umwambie nipee moja atakia. Anakataa na wewe ndio umempea. Praise God. There are Christians like those. Wanakuja wanalia, Mungu anawabless. Then Mungu anamwambia bariki hiyo sister. Hapana. Watu wanapenda kuomba. Sasa wewe umeomba Mungu akukupea. Amen. Mimi hii kitu imeniapenia mpaka siku hizi nimeacha hata kutoa ushuhuda. Unapata mtu anakusimamisha kwa sababu wewe simama. Unasimama. Ndugu acha nikwambie, nimeenda kutafuta kazi ya kuosha nguo sijapata. Haki niko na tatibu. Nilikuwa nataka 200 ninunulie watoto saba. Na sasa hivi umestep out kwa job. Sasa unashindwa Mungu sasa hii. This is very particular. Na unakuambia sina cash. Niko na simu. Haya, leta simu basi. You send her whatever God puts in your heart. Sometimes when I talk at church, there is a day we went to New Life. Magali ziko parking nje, mom there is like 500 cars. Too many cars. And then a guy, out of all those people, picks you. He comes and says, excuse me brother, when you're church kisha, watu wako nje ni wengi. Sasa, anakutaga tu wewe. Anakuambia, nimetoka kwa nyumba watoto watakula. Baka siku moja nijiuliza Mungu hii ni mti ya gani. Sasa, wewe fanya ile kitu tunafanyia. So, nikiangalia hapa ni gari. Hapa ni gari. Watu wamejaa. Sasa, unauliza Mungu, mbona huja Mungu mtupa kwako? God knows mature sons. And he knows babies. Anajua kupeleka huyo mtu kwa mtoto, huyo mtu atatoroka. So, and again, ukikuza mfuko, you have like 2K. This guy is asking for one. So, where is the same sina? Where would I do in my heart of hearts, iko? Sasa unashindwa aliona lakini unajua akujui. Amen. The hallmark of a son, number one, we love other people. Number two, we forgive other people. Number three, and I think number three wraps it up. It is us walking in obedience as children of God. It is a battle. It's not easy. Because the devil knows the moment you keep obeying God, you keep judging him. He was in heaven. He became rebellious. Akafukuzwa. So, the Bible verse I wanted to discuss is the prodigal son. Luke chapter, is it 14? The story of the prodigal son. Jamaa akiona baba yake, maji ilikuwa safi. Alikuwa anakula vizuri. Akafika mahali, akaona kukaa na baba, it is boring. Let me also say this, and this is a disclaimer. Sometimes Christianity looks boring. Let's just say the truth. It looks boring. The only beauty about it, it's very peaceful. It's very peaceful. When you follow God, my goodness, the peace that God gives you, I mean, Mungu akupei vieti. Kitu ya kwanza Mungu anakupenda ni amani. Na wale watu wafuati Mungu, hata wakuwe na vieti, hata wakuwe na nini. The Bible says, there is no peace to the wicked. Amen. Wako na kila kitu, but they are never peaceful. They are not happy people. So, jamaa kuna baba yake, wanakula vizuri, akafika mahali akaona hapana. Hapa kwa fadhi ya kushiki. And you see, in that story, the father will not coerce you if you want your inheritance uende. Kuna watu wanafika wanasema wokovu imekuwa. Wacha Mungu nipe space, niende nipige sherehe. Mungu anasema hivyo ndio unataka eh, mpatie nafasi aende. Mtu anaenda anakula na nguruwe, unakula na swai. Amen. Because the next thing we see is that there is degeneration. This guy was suffering. Now watch this, and this goes back to what I said a few moments ago. The Bible says that when the man, the son, came to himself, praise God, wanasema alijirudi. Let me ask you, kuna malaika alikuja akamflashia akamwambia rudi kwa baba? Yeye mwenyewe alisema, and this is how the guy started arguing, lakini kwa baba yangu kuna slaves wanakula viti kuliko vile mimi nakula. Amen. Hapana. This is enough. I will go back to my father, apologize to him, afadhali anitreat kama slave, because jamaa alikuwa anajua slaves wanakula fork and knife. Hapa hapo jamaa anang'ang'ana na manguruwe. That in the kingdom of God, hata ukiwa mtu anaosha choo, the peace that we are given all of us is the same. Praise God. You know, sometimes people think that when you are a pastor, you stand in front here, you have special grace than those who are seated. No, 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 no. In the kingdom of God, if you are obeying God, we are all given the same peace. Amen? Because peace is priceless. You can't buy peace. Since you understand the people, you say, money can buy a bed, but not sleep. It can buy food, but not appetite. It can buy books, but no brains. Kuna vitu pesa hizi fanya. Amen. Eh, unaweza kuwa na kitanda na ulani, mapepo zinakusumbusha, unakimbisha usiku mzima. Unaamka asubuhi umechoka. You go to bed to rest, you wake up not rested. What is that? You are being tormented. All I wanted to say is this, that God expects us as his children to adhere to his standards. Amen. Now, let me say this. Mzazi akiwa na standards hauna shida, unafuata. Lakini Mungu akiwa na standards unaanza kuleta shida. Because remember, God cannot change his standards to accommodate me. But I can follow his standards and they will accommodate me as a father. Praise God. And when you start walking in obedience, it is a sure sign that you have matured as a Christian. Amen. Because maturity sasa inafika, mtoto anajua si kila kitu unaomba baba anakupea. Na unaelewa baba yako anataka nini. Swali, are we interrogated this Bible to know exactly what God wants? Because top on the list when I read the Bible from Genesis to Revelation is obedience to the commandments of God. That is top number one, obeying him. Now you can't obey him if he is not number one in your life. Because even the first commandment, you shall have no other gods. Yani Mungu anajieka top. Anasema, mimi ndio number one. Na ndio number one, ile kitu nasema ndio nafanya. You see, these are called relationship dynamics. Rules of engagement. Amen? Let me come down to this. And we were discussing this yesterday. When a man is married, or a woman is married, do you come home the time you want? Ukiolewa, utakuja nyumbani ile time unataka. Useme wewe uko baba 18 na uko na meno 32, wewe ni mtu mkubwa, utakuja ile saa ile unataka. Can you do that? Praise God. Praise God. This side is very quiet. Do you come home the time you want? Why? Kuna mahali umeandika sheria number 1, thou shall be at home at 6. Kuna sheria imeandikwa hivyo. Kwa nini watu wanakuja nyumbani? Aya, let me flip the question and ask in another way. When you are living alone, when ni bachelor, unakuwa na limit ya kukuja nyumbani? Thank you. Now, this is what they say. Freedom without limits is bondage. Freedom without boundaries is bondage. I think we need to digest that. Ati, I am free to do anything at any time, the way I want. Unajikuta umeingia kwa jela. Ati pombe, nitakunywa vile nataka. Unapata umelala kwa mtaro. Amen. Now, it is because you thought you are free and you don't have limits, you end up in bondage. That is how addictions occur. I will drink anything, I will smoke anything, and nothing will happen to me. No, 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 no. You are free to make the decision, but you are not free to control the consequences of your decisions. Man is free to the degree you will make a decision, but consequences, they lie outside your control. Now, you decide, and the decision decides. Praise God. So basically, why we were saying that, we were saying this, that even in a family union, as a man, a man in the house were married, can you go and sleep vile unataka mahali unataka? Ukuje kesho asubuhi sema nilichelewa nikalala mahali nilikuwa. Can you do that? Why? There are expectations from your spouse. Ukuje saa fulani, ulale saa fulani, isivyo? Na hizo expectations, they make you behave in a certain way. Now, kama our spouses have expectations, what makes us think that God does not have expectations on how we should conduct our lives? Mungu wa expectations, nani ya translate ya into Kiswahili? Matarajio? Matarajio. Mungu akona matarajio vile sisi tunafaa kuishi. Na akona matarajio kama baba. I don't know if you're getting the point. Siyeti akona matarajio, mimi ni Mungu wako. Ukienda inje ya laini, umeisha. No, 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 that's not God. He's saying, I'm a loving father, I don't want you to meddle with sin, because sin will destroy you. Praise God. Amen. You know the analogy? Ya mtoto, shuka meyo na mtoto wakio mdogo anatakanga aguze moto. Praise God. Mumeyo na katoto anatakanga kuguza moto. Wa mama wangapi wanakatanga mtoto asiguze ile moto? Wa mama kwanza. Amtakangi aguze. Okay. Wa baba wangapi tunasema mama wacha aguze ajue vile kunaendelea? Real men in the house. Inua mkono. Zile za muna mkataza anataka kushika. Alafu tunazuka tunasema wacha aguze. Wa baba wangapi tunasema mama hivyo? No, about the experience. Wa baba wangapi? Kama umei sema, one, two. Yeah. Now that makes us fathers. Sisi atuseme ati mungu mtoto asikuze hiyo moto. Sababu tunajua mkimukataza, curiosity yake inaendelea kumwambia hii kitu wananikataza ni mzuri. Sisi tunasema wacha ashike. Unaweka moto hapa na unasoma kando. Shika. Sababu kuna kitu utajua yenye ujui. Na kakiguza. Kesho yake akakujangi hapo. Amen. Why am I saying that? I'm saying that to say this. That sometimes, kuna vitu Mungu anaweza achilia kidogo, ukicheza nayo unachomeka. Unajua, hata the Bible says that those people that God loves, He chastens them. Kama Mungu anakupenda na kunyorosha, si ndio atakunyorosha? Umenyoroshwa. Unashukuru na kujanga hapa fellowship. Papa, tuna bishop. Tunasema bishop anasema unakarango mpaka unakarangika. Hiyo mdomo uko nayo inaisha. Amen. Unaamka asubuhi unasema glory to God. Sasa unaona mtu ako, but let me tell you my brothers and sisters. Unakarango mpaka unakuwa humble. Sivu unajihambo, ile mitu umepindia, inatoa kiburi. Praise God. Hey, unapindia moto, unaambia Mungu nikisurvive hii. Hai minta kuishia. Mungu anakupitisha ndani ya moto. Na kitu moja anaweza wambia na Mungu, Mungu atoangi moto. No, 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 no. God does not remove the fire. But this is what He does. He goes through the fire with you. He gives you grace to go through the fire. Because He understands that hiyo moto ndio inakupurify. Amen. Eh. Na kama unashipenda kushikilia pesa sana, you lose pesa vizuri. Na si kidogo, mpaka inafika mahali unacheka. Praise God. Eh, kuna mtu ninajua ali lose 50k akajinyonga. Guy. Sisi sijui ungekuwa umejinyonga mara ngapi. You will lose 200 times that. Eh, unanunua gari. 600 inapigwa inaisha in 3 months na unanyamaza. Unasikia joto mpaka joto inakuwa na unaendelea. Praise God. When God loves you, the very thing that you want, He tells you to put it on the altar. Imagine Abraham. Let me tell you, when you read the Bible, sometimes you wonder about God. Ameomba Mungu mtoto for 25 years. Isaac amekuja. Alafu Mungu anamwambia, Buda, mambo ni mawili. Unaona huyo mtoto? Toa sacrifice. Na Mungu anajua vitu zingine, haizi kuambia ufanye na wife. Anakuambia kipanzolo. Hadi imagine Abraham akaenda ambie Sarah. Mungu ameniambia nitoe mtoto sacrifice. Unafikiria Sarah angesema wewe ni Mungu? Si jamaa amekula divorce. I can imagine Sarah alikuwa mkisi. Ile nduru angepiga. Because vile yo akisi. Amwambie Mungu ameniambia tuzae mtoto sacrifice. That is why when God loves you, He deals with you on a personal level. Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. God expects us to grow as His children. And again, let me also drop this. Maturity is a process. Praise God. Yeah, it's a process. Say by your word, maturity is a process. And it takes time. Can we say that again? Repeat that. Amen. If you understand that, siwezi taka luta saa hii aanze kuunda maquotation. No. But when he finishes high school and he finishes, I will teach him what I'm doing. He can do it. Praise God. Because at that level, he can handle that. But there are things I expect from him right now as he's growing. Amen. That is why God deals with us individually depending on where we have reached in our walk with him. Amen. Kuna mtu ukimpea 1 million utamwona kanisa. Praise God. Aki kuna mtu ukimpea 1 million ni kile. Ama umpea 10 million dead. 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 Why? Money is a form of power. And power can only be given to people who have shown that they can control it. Praise God. Wao ukitaka kubarikiwa na Mungu pesa mingi, start praying for character. Don't pray for money. Oh God, give me the character that can handle 10 million. Amen. Give me the character that can handle 100 million. I'm serious. Amen. I am telling you, there are people here who give them 100 million and you kill them instantly. They die. Jamaa anakuwa cheesy. Ndi huyo Dubai, South Africa, you will be all over the world. Within 1 year, umekata ujumbe kufia wapi. Amen. That is why when you come to God, you grow in stages and it is incremental. It is degree by degree. The Bible says the path of the righteous gets brighter and brighter. Amen. Brighter and brighter. Sio tunaingia tu hivi bright mara moja. No. And let me tell you, why many people love prosperity preachers is because they promise instant gratification. Amen. But you know, here, and I really thank God for this ministry, we are being taught the word of God unadulterated. The word of God is designed to rebuke us, it's designed to warn us, it's designed to train us, it's designed to help us mature and grow in the things of God. That is what the word of God does. But if you come here and I dramatize, si tulionule jamaa walikuwa na pastor fake, vile walikuwa wanafanyia watu fake miracles. Mpaka wanaenda kuwako wakijua uko na pesa, wanaenda wanafufua mtu huko Ramata, wanakuja wanazika kwa boma yako. Alafu hiyo kitu wamezika, wanaifunga na sodium, sijui ni chloride, ile ina react. So, ama potassium, si tulionule potassium the way ina react. Potassium peke yake ina reacting. So wanafunga hiyo dead body na potassium. So, unajua wanakubebea akili, wamekufuata unajua unakaa rubeste poshe. Wanapanda, wanachimba mali, wanaacha kama miezi mbili, wanajua imemea. So, wanakwambia tunakuja maombi kuna uchawi. Roho wa Bwana anasema kuna uchawi kwako. Wanakuja usiku, wanafika pale. si wanajua mahali kitu hiko, na ule mtu walichimba, ndiye anagaidi mtumishi. Wanaendelea kuomba, wanaendelea kuomba, wanakuambia kuchimba hapa, wanakuchimbisha mahali kama ile tano, ndiyo ujio wanatafuta. Lakini wanajua mahali ile kitu hiko. Ule jamaa kuchimba na wanamuambia, unachimba na mguu ya right, mahali yake ya left, hapo ndiyo hiko. So anaenda anakanyaga mahali right, wanachimba. Anakanyaga right, wanachimba. Akienda weke mguu ya left, wanajua ile kitu walisika hapo. Wanachimbua. Guy, unaona kisikera kono. Na wamekua na mata. Unastuka. Wanasema sasa leta ile maji. Holy, holy water. Yenye wameombea. Si unajua water react with potassium explosively. Unasikia toa. So wanakuja wanasema ile holy water iko na power. Shaka bakaya. Wanafungua chupa. Wanamwagia ile kitu wanasema songa nyuma. Nguvu ya Mungu iko karibu kulipuka hapa. Mukisonga nyuma wakimwaga maji, water reacts ina explode. Tua, tua, kai. Unasema umeleta watu wa Mungu wako na power. Kesho wanakuambia tunataka milioni 5. Wanasema ile pesa wanaitisha. Mungu wako kwa bank saa 2. Anangoja bank ifunguliwe. Apeleka watumishi sadaka ya maombi. Praise God. Jamaa alikuwa na confess. And do you know why? Many people fall victims to those kind of theatrics. People do not love the truth of the word of God. The sincere truth of the word of God. Whereby we may grow. Amen. Christianity is a journey. Amen. And it's a process. We grow. Jamaa anasema, mtu alikuwa anafika kwa bank before ifunguliwe hapo hivi. Na wameitisha 100,000 ama 1 million. Eh. Jamaa anaona vichwa. Gai. Alafu sinamwagiwa maji, ile holy water. Ina react, inatoa moto hapo. Wanajua usiku saa 8. Ayaya, wanajua ni watumishi ya kazi. Do you know why people are deceived like that? Few people love to come to a word-based church where you are taught the word of God so that we can grow in the word of God. We can grow in the things of God. And I say maturity is a and it takes time. Amen. So where she is in a walk with God, I may not be there. But again, it has taken a time. Where I am, it has taken me time. Where you are, it will take you time. Amen. So it is the degree of your commitment to the principles of God that will determine how far and how high you will grow. Praise God. Because this book is a book of promises, principles, and prophecies. So when it comes to promises, ziko. But let me tell you, my brothers and sisters, the quickest shortcut to activate the promises of God is to speak to the principles of God. And one of the main principles is the principle of obedience. And it is a struggle. Obeying God is not a walk in the park. Why? The world is going downstream and you're going upstream. Everybody is drinking. You are saying, no. Everybody wants to party. You Friday unakimbia home. Friday unaenda kesha, unashindwa huyo amegoroka. That's the nature of this thing. Amen. Kila mtu anacheza secular music. Wewe umeamka asubuhi. Ainuliwe Mungu. Kwani unashindwa mtu anaimba vitu gani? But you see, it is that commitment to principles of the kingdom that gives you results. Praise God. Many Christians do not activate the principles of the kingdom so that they can get the results they want. Chief among those principles is obedience. And obedience is a principle for blessings of God. Deuteronomy 28 talks about the blessings of? The blessings of? Watu wamenyamaza hapo. Mmelala, hebu simama. Simama hii group yote. Watu wamesikia baridi mpaka wamelala. Wapigie makofi wakisimama. Wapigie makofi wakisimama. Simameni. Just stand. Okay. Wamesikia baridi sana. You know when I'm talking and people are not responding. I love you my sisters and brothers. Wapigie makofi. Amen. Aye, wakae chini. This side is active. Lakini kuna watu wamelala. Na nyinyi simama, wapigie makofi. No, just stand up. I'm winding up. So, church, this side, we say Obedience is a
process.
And it takes to do what? To mature, right? So, Simameni Hotel, stand up, all of you. Amen. We finished, and this is my parting shot. Christianity is a process. Growing in the things of God is a process. But it needs commitment. It is blood, sweat, and tears. It is fasting. It is reading the word. It is listening to sermons. It is practicing. The Bible says not only being hearers of the word, but being doers, so that we don't deceive ourselves. That whatever we've heard from here, we go and put it in practice, so that God can give us grace to obey Him. It is not easy to obey God, but it is possible. Praise God. And it will take time for us to mature and grow in the things of God as sons and daughters. So one of the things we need to understand is that as sons, there are expectations that God has concerning us. And those expectations is for everybody. Amen? Everybody. Starting from the reverend way to the youngest child, God expects all of us to obey Him. He expects us to grow and mature in the things of God. Amen? With those very many remarks, may the good Lord bless and guide us as we engage in the kingdom principles. God bless you.